Hi friends, welcome to Discover Agriculture YouTube channel. If you are not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe now. The coconut is a tropical fruit plant grown on a large scale in a number of countries in tropical and subtropical areas. The place of origin, though contradictory, is believed to be somewhere in South Asia, Malaysia. In India, coconut palms are grown on the entire coastal belt. Major share goes to Kerala, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, followed by Goa, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh and Orissa. Importance. Every part of the coconut palm is useful to mankind. It supplies food, fuel, drink, oil and shelter to us. The wet kernel, desiccated copra, coconut water, cream flour, oil, cake, toddy, husk, fiber, shell, coir, wood and leaves are used for one purpose or the other. Climate. The coconut palm grows well in an equatorial climate. The long spells of hot and dry weather, severe winters and extremes of temperatures are not favorable for coconut growing. However, it thrives well up to 1000 meters above the sea level. The well-distributed rainfall ranging from 100 to 300 centimeters is favorable. Soil. The coconut palm can grow in a wide range of soil conditions ranging from laterite, alluvial, red, sandy loam having pH range from 5.5 to 8. Soil should be fertile and good drainage without any hard substratum within one of the surface. Varieties. There are number of varieties grown in different parts, which are classified as tall varieties. West Coast tall, Lakshadweep, Andaman, Kappadam, Laguna, San Raman. Dwarf varieties. Chowghat, Dwarf Green, Dwarf Orange, Malayong Dwarf, Mangi Pot. Hybrid varieties. T into D, D into T. Propagation. The coconut palm is commonly propagated by seeds. Since the productivity of the palm depends on the quality of the seedlings, utmost importance should be given to select the best nuts. The mother palms should be regular bearers giving annual yield of more than 100 nuts with the copra content of 150 grams per nut. The mother palm should be within the age group of 20 to 40 years. These palms producing barren nuts and shedding immature nuts in large number should be discarded for the nursery purpose. Planting and season. The planting distance depends on the type of plant or variety, soil type and whether monoculture or associated culture or mixed culture is adopted. Distance should be in such a way that the fronds, leaves of planting adjacent palms to do not overlap when fully grown. The spacing may be 7 to 8 meters both ways for tall varieties. Well-developed and well-grown seedlings about 1 to 2 years old should be selected for planting. The planting should be done on onset of monsoon, for which the pits of 0.75 by 0.75 by 0.75 meters should be opened and filled with a mixture of compost, bone meal, superphosphate, well before the monsoon. Inticulturing. Weeding and stirring the soil around the plant should be done frequently. The interspace may be kept clean or utilized for taking other crops, seasonals or perennials. Care of young plants. The young palms need proper care during the early stages of growth from transplanting up to fifth year. The seedlings should be protected from stray cattle. During summer months, shade and frequent watering must be provided to the young palms to avoid casualties. The care should be taken to see that the collar and leaf axils of the seedlings are not covered by mud, water or soil. Special horticulture practices. The dwarf varieties are considered on self-pollinating while tall varieties are considered cross-pollinating. Interplanting of mixed planting be done to increase the fruit set. Honey bees are considered to be very useful for pollination and be reared in the vicinity of palm cultures. Irrigation. The coconut palm requires large quantities of water for its normal growth and timely production. In normal conditions and in absence of rains, every palm needs about 16 to 18 liter water daily. Regular irrigation helps to increase the fruit set, improve size and copra content. However, stagnation of water and ill-drained conditions should be strictly avoided. Nutrition. To get a good yield, palms should be fertilized regularly and with a quick frequency, Bimonthly applications are more beneficial. Every well-grown palm should be applied with 25 kg of FYM, 1 kg of 5:10:5 micronutrients or Mycheme at 2 kg. Palm once in a year should be applied to avoid any micronutrient disorders. Plant protection. Important pests: Rhinoceros beetle, red palm weevil, leaf-eating caterpillar and cockchafer beetle are the major insect pests. Occasionally mealybug, rat and slug also become troublesome. Bud rot and leaf rot and root wilt can cause severe damage to palms. One should be very alert to notice the symptoms of any pest and take the suitable control measures. Close planting should be avoided and plantation should be kept weed-free and clean. The palms should be cleared off at least once in a year. Providing a good drainage and feeding the palms with balanced nutrition is useful to keep palms healthy. Harvesting and yield. The well-developed nuts should be harvested 1 month earlier to full maturity. Harvesting of nuts is a skilled and risky job. 2 to 6 harvestings can be done yearly. Average 80 to 100 nuts are harvested per tree per year. Post-harvest handling and sale. The nuts are hardy and can be kept for a long time. Nuts harvested at less than 9 months age will be dried, spoiled or without a very thin layer of copra. Copra is removed and then processed for different purposes or dried and stored and sold as dry copra.
When most people think about a coconut, they either think about this, a young, green or drinking coconut, or this, a fully mature, brown coconut. But these are just two of the many stages of a coconut's ripeness or maturity.
A single coconut tree can hold up to 14 racks or bunches of coconuts.
So going down the line from a tree that we harvested, we can see all the different ages. 9 months, 10 months. As it matures, the water gets sweeter and the meat begins to build. 11 months, 12 months, 13 months, 14 months. At this stage, the coconut's getting mature and the meat is usable for milk. This is coconut information.
In order to understand the life cycle of the coconut, we first have to go up into the crown. Every coconut starts its life from this, a coconut flower pod. The flowers that emerge from these pods are huge and attract bees with their sweet nectar.
The flowers are both male and female. The male flowers open first, and next the females open. If this gets pollinated right here, this will become a mature coconut.
It takes 6 months for a coconut to mature from a flower to a usable drinking coconut.
The flower has now become a rack of coconuts. The unique thing about a coconut tree is, unlike other trees, it produces fruit all year round. So it pushes out one of those flowers every moon cycle, which matures into a rack. And then the next moon cycle, it pushes out another one and another one in a spiral pattern, reaching towards the sky. So the younger nuts are on the top and the older ones are down below. They've been maturing for up to 14 months. So when we look at this tree right here, each rack is roughly one moon cycle older or younger than the next one. And it actually wraps around several times.
Each month, the water inside the coconuts sweetens and the meat thickens. At the final stages of maturity, the coconuts turn brown and fall naturally from the tree.
These are the fully mature seeds of the coconut tree, the brown coconuts. Full of rich, healthy fats and used to make the best oil known to man. And if conditions are just right, this brown coconut will sprout.
Planted wisely and cared for, it will grow into a fully mature tree in just a few years.
Hope you like this video. Please do subscribe Discover Agriculture channel and recommend our channel to your friends. If you have any suggestions, please comment below. It may help our farmers too. Share this video with all friends. Thank you for watching this video. Have a good day.